Good afternoon, Hatters. It is a sort of beautiful Sunday. We are still waiting for the tropical storm weather to come and get us. We are not going to get the tropical storm. I did have Disney pass to go today, but I chose tomorrow because I feel like tomorrow more people will cancel with the chances of the rain coming later tonight. And with the storm leaving by tomorrow afternoon, or at least tomorrow morning. Now, as you know, I haven't done a podcast in about 2.5 weeks, close to three. That's because I've been going to the parks more. And there really hasn't been any real, you know, breaking news, technically. But I can say this. Today we're going to talk about, and this is the one thing I was thinking to myself, and I said to Megan, I said, oh, what are they going to do? Because Halloween, Not So Scary Halloween, would have started in a week and a half from today. Are they going to just leave the park as it is? Are they going to decorate it? What are they going to do? Well, we just found out today that Halloween at Disney, yes, is canceled, but they are going to decorate for the park. So the park will still be decorated as Halloween. So I thought that was pretty cool because I was wondering if they were going to do it at all. And that would explain why most of August is taken, because a lot of people are going to try to get to see these decorations before, you know, October. And what I found out is, yes, they are going to go up, but they have no date of when they're going up. So you're just going to be seeing them, and maybe when you see me in the park recording, you might see them in the park pop up, and it might be at a slow pace. I don't think they're regularly going to do what they used to do a long time ago, which is get it up within a week. So I think it's going to be sporadic, which is pretty I'm okay with it, because now that there is no party, I understand that they're not going to do that. Now, here's what I'm thinking. And I'm wondering if they are going to do the characters' cavalcades where they're in Halloween costumes. And if on Halloween, because it looks like Halloween's going to get canceled this year, that's here nor there. If they still do a little trick-or-treat for those who come into the park. I don't know. Because I don't know if they're stocked up on candy. I don't know what they're planning on doing. There's a lot of things that are going to come out in the next couple of weeks about what they're planning on doing for this Halloween season, even though there is no party. Because obviously they're going to have something to keep the interest of the guests. And I think that's pretty fun. And I think that's pretty cool that they're going to do that. The decorations are beautiful. And we still have no word on what's going on with Christmas. That we probably won't hear for another, probably next month. September, we'll probably find out more about what's going to happen to Christmas. If they're going to do the Christmas party, or are they just going to just cancel it altogether and just try for next year. Now, on another note about Halloween is, as you all know, I did say that I had to cancel my trip to Disneyland. And Disneyland had just made an announcement that they are canceling the Oogie Boogie Bash. So that was what we were going for in the first place. So now that it's canceled, I am still having a fight with Expedia about, you know, hotel and flight, because apparently they're trying to not give me back my money. But I now have to wait till September 1st to put in a claim that states that Disneyland is not open, so you must give me back all my money. Or at least a voucher for next year, which me and Megan are okay with, because we are planning on going next year. Now that our trip our cruise that we had next year got pushed back to now way to the end of next year. So now we're not even doing that cruise until October of next year now. They pushed that back for the safety of others. And so now we have February open. So if Disneyland is open by February and a lot of things are better, that would probably be the time we would probably go to Disneyland. Now, here's where I'm going to say to you. Expedia and all these other little sites are great, but I wish I went with Mickey Travels. And I wish, because Mickey Travels is, in my opinion, probably the better place to have gone. I probably would have saved a little bit more money. Not by much, but they would have helped out a little bit more than what Expedia does. And I wouldn't have had this problem because, at least with the travel agency, I would have been able to cancel through them instead of going through all these third parties. So I got to deal with that. But I like what's going to happen soon with Disney and the holidays coming up, which is what I enjoy. I enjoy the holidays times at Disney because of decorations and the different smells around the park become, you know, most people say they smell pumpkin, but I like the other smells. It's weird. I don't know where I was going with that one. But I will say this. I cannot wait to see all these decorations go up soon. And I think once I see that, it gives me a realization that 2020 is almost over. So, and it makes me realize, hey, we're not that far away to getting out of this dreadful year. Now, I will tell you this. As of yesterday, well, not as of yesterday, but about a couple of months ago, but to yesterday, the package came in. My official membership for D23 has come in. So now, according to my wife, I am the ultimate Disney fan. The only thing I'm missing is a DVC. I have an annual pass. I have a D23 membership. I have stocks in Disney. Like I said, I got 10 stocks in Disney, which are okay. They're not that great right now, the stocks, but they're doing better. And I believe, yeah, I do have a membership for the cruises, but I never really use it because it's just like a regular membership. But yeah, I am a D23 member, which now allows me to go. I just got to pay an extra $30 next year for Megan. But when I pay the extra $30, me and Megan get to go to D23 next year in California. So there's the other thing we're thinking about. Can we get our money back from Expedia so that we can take our trip to California in August of next year then? That way we can go to D23 and Disneyland at the same time. D23, if many of you who do not know, is basically like Comic-Con. But it's all Disney. And the CEO, all the vice presidents are going to be there. They all break news of any brand new thing that comes out of Disney. So that's where they announced Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. That's where they announced Toy Story Land. So this year, there is no D23. There wasn't one. This was their skip year. It was supposed to be like, I believe it was Hong Kong or Japan or something like that. Or maybe they moved it. I know they moved it somewhere, but it's like a smaller scale. So it's not a bigger, it's not like this big giant Comic-Con like building. It's a little bit smaller. But next year, which is sad because next year starts the end of August. It usually is. But that is also before the 50th of Disney World. So here's where my dilemma makes, and this is where I thought about it, is Disney is going to next summer start the 1 year because it starts, it doesn't start from October 1st, they said, which was odd to me because when I heard that statement, I was like, wait a minute, you're not going to start the year-long 50th celebration on the 50th of October 1st of 2021? So that was a little odd for me to hear. They said they don't have a date yet, but they said it was going to start in the summer. That could still be pushed back, and it might actually be, start on October 1st. And this is because of Tron has been pushed back. All the construction on Disney property all have been pushed back. So they're not going to open up when they originally said they were going to. Like right now, Ratatouille was supposed to be open in March. Never happened because Disney closed. Now they are looking to try to get it open this month or next month. It actually has to get open next month because they did say that it is opening up in the summer of 2020. And the summer ends next month. So they are looking at trying to get this thing open because they didn't have a lot of people doing the construction. And they just had to do a little tweaking and all that other stuff. That's all they had to do. But with this D23, we would be able to get all the breaking news. We can get all these nice collectibles because, as we all know, I collect a lot of Disney stuff that is worth money. Now, in that D23 stuff that I got, they gave me a lot of collectibles. Like, these pins are only strictly for D23 members. And not many people can get a D23 membership. I mean, you can. You just got to go to their website. It's just a lot of money to spend. I got it on discount because I'm an annual pass holder and I have stocks and all that stuff. So I got it on a discount. And you only got to pay it once a year. And next year, I think I only got to pay $130 because I got to put the extra 30, so 160 for a year again. So that way we can go to D23 and we get first dibs at tickets. And I want to go to this. This has actually been a dream of mine to go to D23 because D23 is, you can learn, there's people there that will teach you history of Disney. You can learn how to draw there. You can look at all the artifacts that were lost that sellers bring, that, you know, buyers have bought these things from the original Disneyland and have brought it to the convention just to show you. And you can take pictures with it. So it's pretty cool. It's a lot of artifacts about Disney that are hidden away but only come out really once a year or once every 2 years. So that is something I am very excited about. So yeah, D23, you can meet celebrities as well. I thought that was pretty awesome that there was some pretty good celebrity lineups last year. And was it last year? Yeah, last year. I was a little upset that I couldn't go. I wanted to go, but we already had thought it because we were going to Disneyland for our honeymoon. There was no reason to go to Disneyland earlier. So, but let's move on to our next segment. And it looks like new merchandise from The Nightmare Before Christmas has made its way into Walt Disney World. So you got a Jack Skellington Santa. You got the Oogie Boogie. And the snake too, really? Oh, that's cool. The snake's there. And the Wolfman plush. I like it. I like it a lot. Yes, if you're hearing banging in the background, it is actually my neighbor upstairs. Her kid bangs every single day, so this is what we deal with every day until almost the time we wake up to the time we go to bed, and maybe even later. Sometimes she's up until 2 o'clock in the morning. That's what I just want to let you know. The movie adaptation of Black is Beauty. I don't know. Is that the one with No. It is based on the adaptation of Black Beauty. I think this is the one where I heard that Lin-Manuel was getting involved in. But I'm not 100% sure. I don't know much about that. But I do know that the Muppets have returned to the Disney Plus with the new show. I haven't watched it. I was going to watch it today, but I plan to watch it soon. So I am very excited, mostly because of I've been watching baseball and hockey. And my team has not been doing so well. So I kind of need something to get my mind off sports now, because honestly, this is just sad to watch. So the Disney Plus has basically been my scapegoat. Along with regular TV. But Hollywood Studios is basically sold out all the way until September. Now, I am planning on going again August 27th, but now we just found out today that they did open the Beauty and the Beast theater, but they changed it. Now it is socially distanced, but it is now no longer the Beauty and the Beast show. It is now considered the Disney Society Orchestra and Friends show at Disney's Hollywood Studios. And from the pictures, it looks like it is, well, let me just read you. The show features a six-piece orchestra playing movie and TV tune guests will find around Disney Hollywood Studios, culminating in a finale with appearances from the Beauty and the Beast characters. So the characters from Beauty and the Beast will come out and they will basically do a little dance to the songs. Hey, look at this. I also just noticed that Shop Disney is offering a free gift with a $75 purchase for limited time. I wonder what the gift is. It's got a picture of Donald on it. It's quacktastic, it says. It looks like you can get anything for free that's $25 if you that's eligible. So that's pretty cool that Disney is doing that. That's pretty nice of them. So crowds over at Magic Kingdom have been getting very, very bad. If you notice in the new episode I'm about to post out today on YouTube, we went to Magic Kingdom and we said, you know what? Let's not go early in the morning. Well, that was our mistake. We probably should have woke up early in the morning and went that day, because we wanted to spend the whole time at Disney until 7 o'clock, only because we did find out that Magic Kingdom, Animal Kingdom, and Hollywood Studios are basically all sold out all the way through August 24th. I have August 24th to go back. I had today, but like I said, I didn't feel like it because of the storm and everything. So there's that. But I will say this. If you wait till after midnight, everything changes over, so there are chances that something opens up. You just gotta stay up until 12 o'clock in the morning, 12:30 in the morning to find something that's available. That's what I do. Now, I might try to see if something will be available tomorrow. Right now, there is nothing available. There could still be something available tomorrow for me to go to the Magic Kingdom to see what it looks like after the tropical storm. But who knows? But the crowds have been very bad, and you will see it, that we actually did have to leave to go to SeaWorld. That's how bad Disney was, that we booted ourselves off Disney property to go to Disney rival, well, maybe third rival. We're not going to say they're the number one rival, but the third rival, SeaWorld. So we went there, and the crowds were significantly so much less. Now, I also heard from a bunch of other YouTubers and everything that Disney Springs has been a nightmare. They don't enforce the rule about you cannot drink and eat while walking. So they're not really enforcing it as much. And they came out with new masks. I heard a Haunted Mansion mask just came out. And the line was forever, I heard. They didn't even bother getting a line because it would just take forever. And by the time they got up there, the masks were sold. It's crazy here because like I've been saying, and you notice on my other YouTube shows, that the crowd's been low. Now no one's afraid of the COVID-19. Everyone knows that Florida came out with the announcement that Disney and all the theme parks have not had any traces of COVID, but they have found out that people are getting more COVID just going out to the grocery store. They said that Targets and Walmarts, people have been getting it more there than they have been over theme parks. There have not been any cases. And Disney is not going to exploit it, but Advent Health, who works with Disney, probably would make the announcement. Because as a health profession, they probably will make an announcement for people to say, hey, look, yeah, these people, we have had to turn people away. But it looks like they haven't. The only reason they've been turning people away is because they're not wearing the proper masks. You're not allowed to wear gaiters no more. You're not allowed to wear a mask with valves or holes in them or mesh. They have to be straight, ear-looped masks. If you're not wearing that, you're not getting in the park. Sorry. And Universal and SeaWorld also implied that as well, because when we went to SeaWorld, they also said the same thing. So just know that for when you decide to come to the parks. Disneyland is planning on starting their hotel reservations on September 1st. Now, they were supposed to open up last month. A week ago last month. And they were supposed to just open their Disneyland Hotel and a Grand, not the Grand Floridian, what am I talking about? The Grand Californian. Now, that never happened because of the governor of California, I'm sorry, didn't want to open the parks. Now, some are open in California, but they're not doing rides. They're doing, like, little walkthroughs, and they're giving, like, tours and stuff. I don't understand how that's working out, but apparently it's working. Knott's Berry Farm over in California is doing a food and wine type thing without rides. So it's just food and wine. And apparently it's working. So, but they are going to be taking reservations starting September 1st. So is that a inclination that they are going to open? We don't know. We're never going to know until California decides to make their decision. We all know that California is a complete nightmare, and they don't know how to run anything. So, but let's go to our next segment. Shanghai Disneyland, who was the first to reopen, just got their stage shows, their parades, and fireworks all working, all socially distancing. Now, is that a good thing? Yeah, actually, it is a good thing, because now they're showing America on Disneyland and Disney World properties that you can do fireworks while socially distanced. And SeaWorld in Orlando is the only theme park that is doing fireworks. And so is Busch Gardens in Tampa that are doing fireworks. They're the only ones who are doing it. All the other theme parks are not doing their regular, you know, shows or anything like that. SeaWorld is the only one who is doing it in Orlando, though. And it's working out perfectly fine. So I'm going to say this, maybe by November we can get stage shows and maybe fireworks back. Maybe. Don't quote me. I said this is my opinion. But the way things are going and how Shanghai is showing the world. Now, granted, Shanghai is not, Disney does not have any control over Shanghai. If Disney did, they probably would not have any of their fireworks or shows working or anything like that. They are owned by the Chinese government. Which is why Hong Kong is still closed, reclosed again, because of the government is, there's a lot of things going on with the government that is causing Hong Kong to stay closed. A lot of them think it's got to be COVID, which probably what I'm thinking, because a lot of, that's what I'm thinking. China is not releasing how many people have COVID over there. They probably still have a significant amount. But they are showing that they got their shows running, everything, and they socially distance. Maybe there's a way they could do it here in Florida. Who knows? We won't know for a couple more months. Because honestly, I don't think they're going to keep these fireworks and stage shows off for a whole year until next September. There's no, I don't think they're going to do that because the Actors Union is not going to be very happy about that. So we'll see in a couple more months of what happens with that situation. On my final note to end the podcast today, it's going to be a short one. Like I said, I do more in the park than I do podcasts lately. If something big happens, I'll definitely podcast it. But the announcement for the prequel for Beauty and the Beast live action film with Gaston and LeFou is now being called Little Town. And if you all know, this is a tribute to the beginning part of the song, Belle's Song. And it's a tribute to Howard Ashman, who recently died back in the early 90s, late 80s, who is also going to have a Disney Plus special coming out very soon. So look out for that. I'll probably be doing a review like I did for the Sherman Brothers, so look out for that review. So I would like to say thank you, everyone, for listening, and I hope you all have a magical day. Bye. Bobby Bob.